Hello, 7th and 8th grade cello players. This is Skill Builder 10, and this week we're going to continue looking at a day at Disneyland. Last time we made it from measure 1 to measure 37, mostly looking at the Mickey Mouse March. Today we're going to start at measure 38 and go all the way to the end of measure 58. This is a tune called The Great Outdoors that I don't expect many of you to know. In fact, I didn't know it, and almost all of the high schoolers didn't know it before we started learning this, but we have come to love it, and I hope that you do too. If you would like to listen to this melody, you can type in The Great Outdoors Disneyland on YouTube, and you'll find a video of it. And then I also have the short snippet of just this part, measures 38 through 58, on my YouTube channel, so you can hear our arrangement. Hey guys, thanks so much for watching your Skill Builder. I'm here in my kitchen because we are going to play a game this week called What's in Miss Allen's Fridge. You all have until the next day one, that means by 11:59 p.m. on day six, to send me an email with a guess of five things that are in my refrigerator. Whoever guesses the most things correct will win a prize. So make sure you email me your guesses before the next day one, and let's get back to the Skill Builder. And just like last time, the first two things we're going to look at are the key signature and the time signature to make sure we know what they are in this section because they do change throughout the piece. So let's look for the time signature first. It actually changed in measure 36 and will apply all the way through what we're going to be playing today. And measure 36, it changes back to 4/4. So that's a good thing for us. We are all more than comfortable with 4/4. It's the time signature that we most often play in. And so we don't have to worry about any of that 6/8 stuff that we talked about last time. So now I'd like you to check out at measure 38, look for your key signature. And you might be saying, oh, they forgot to put the key signature in. I'm not seeing anything. Well, actually, the key signature is nothing. There are no sharps and no flats, which means everything is natural. Now, where that can trip you up are on your C's and on your F's because we are so used to playing those notes as sharp. So as we get to C's and F's in this section, we're going to have to remember to play them as natural notes. So normally it's going to be two fingers that you'll have to do when it comes to the D and A string. So F natural and C natural are both two fingers. Sometimes there's an accidental in there, and so we do play the F sharp or C sharp, but the rule in this key signature of all naturals is C naturals and F naturals, okay? Now, as cello players, you are really going to love this particular section of the music because you are actually featured very prominently at the beginning. So in measure 38, there are two measures of bass introduction. And then the pickup to measure 40 is just cellos and bass. This is your time to shine with the melody. This is kind of a tricky melody. Once you get it in your head, it's a lot easier to play. But what I'm going to do is play this in sections. So right now I'm doing the pickup to measure 40. And I'm going to go all the way to the end of measure 41 without playing the pickup into measure 42. Let me play it for you once. You can listen, and then you can play it with me at home. Okay? So here we go. This is what it's going to sound like. Try it with me. Set that first finger down on the D string. Get ready to do an up bow. One and two and ready. Here we go. Alright, and there are some slurs in there that are a little bit tricky. You might have to go back and do those slowly to make sure you get them. But now let me do for you the pickup to 42. So same deal, I'm going to do 42 and 43, but not the pickup to 44. Okay, so go ahead and listen once, and then you can play with me. It sounds like this. So it starts the same and then the ending is different. Go ahead and play with me from the pickup to 42. Ready? Here we go. Let's do what we've learned so far. Pick up to measure 40 all the way to the end of 43. One, two, ready? Here we go. We haven't had to play any C naturals or F naturals yet, but they are coming in this next section. Let me play for you the pickup to 44, and I actually am going to do pickup to 44 all the way to the end of 47. So go ahead and listen once, and then we'll do it together. It sounds like this. Let's do it together, but before we do that, you might have noticed the accidental in measure 46. That is in E flat. It's a low one on the D string. And then in measure 47, there's a natural sign in parentheses next to the E. That's called a courtesy accidental. It means they didn't have to write it, but they're writing it to help you out. Just bring your first finger back to where it belongs. So instead of an E flat, we have an E natural. So let's do pick up to 44. Don't forget those C naturals, two fingers on the A string. One, two, ready, here we go. Awesome. Let's put that all together. Pick up to 40 all the way to 48. One, two, ready, here we go. Sorry, I was looking at the wrong line. One more time, pick up to 40. Ready? Here we go. Here comes C naturals. Is a really tricky part, and it's a very important part for the cello section. So I would recommend you take some time working on that. And if you need to have something to play along with, there is a video of just your part, just the cello part. I would pull up that video. It's faster than what we just practiced, so I would go and change the playback speed, maybe to 0.9 or 0.85. Practice with it at that speed until you're comfortable, and then you can speed it up because it will be faster when we play it in the concert, okay? So that's your time to shine, cellos. Take some time to work on that this week. 48 is where the violins take over with the melody. And you come in at 49 with this little echo. It'll be easier to show you what it's like with everybody there, but you and the violas go like this at measure 49. Just a little echo. We'll deal with that when we're in person. And then let's go to measure 52. You have some half notes. That first note, think twice before you play it because you want to make sure you're playing the right note. It is not an F sharp, it's an F natural. So you have plenty of time to think about it and put down two fingers, not three. Here are those half notes. Ready? Here we go. Then you rest for four, one, two, three. Four, one, two, rest. And then you get a C on beat four. And that actually is just cellos and bass. So we in the high school have worked on playing that C at the end of measure 56 nice and loud. It is accented and it brings us into 57 where everyone in the orchestra has the same rhythm. Let me play for you your part at 57. It sounds like this. You may have noticed some accidentals in there in the measure 57. You have an F sharp, so D, E, three finger F sharp and G, just like we're used to playing. And then in measure 58, we have A, B, two finger C natural, three finger C sharp, and then four fingers high D. That's a little bit unusual. You get to play every single finger on the A string. A, one, two, three, four. You don't get to do that often, so you can take advantage of that. Let's play right at measure 57 together. Sorry, we have some third graders going to lunch. Hopefully that's not too distracting. Let's start from measure 57. One, two, ready, and here we go. All right, excellent. Let's go back to the beginning. We will put this all together, and then you will have the week to work on this on your own. Right where you come in, pick up to measure 40, and we will actually practice counting the rests in this as well. So right where you come in, a one, two, ready, here we go. Natural one, two, here we go. go. Disneyland. This is a very prominent cello part in the piece, so you really want to spend some time working on this so you can be comfortable on it in the concert. You'll have from today all the way until the next day one to practice it on your own, and then we'll start working on it in class together. All right, so everyone have a great day, and I will see you in class.